Proton released an AI agent called Lumo, and yes, it shares many similarities to a certain dog AI agent, but with a cat. I have yet to actually do my first search with it, and so this is a live demo as well as showing where it is in the Proton ecosystem, comparing it to other solutions like DuckAI as well as Kaji. You can test this right now, I'll leave a link down in the description. Now they say no logs, zero access encryption, no data sharing, not used to train AI, open, and then they have a chart. And then they also have some other new features here, which is ghost mode, web search, so you can search the web with this, file uploads, and then Proton Drive integration. Really want to try out. So this is a bit different from other approaches. So to compare to something like DuckAI, DuckAI, you're essentially relying on DuckDuckGo to proxy the request for you to a different agent. So if I go here and I just do the default suggest a title for a blog post, you go ahead and do this, but you can actually change the model here. And again, they're just going to be proxying this. And so there is a lot of privacy you gain here, but it's not a trustless model because there is still some trust in DuckDuckGo. And then Kaji does something fairly similar, which is they go ahead and proxy it. They have privacy practices in place to make sure nothing's tracked. Proton is doing something a bit different in their defense here because this is fully end-to-end encrypted. So they, not even Proton, can access chat history. In terms of LLMs, this is a bit unclear, but I had to essentially get this from just random guesses as well as asking the AI model. But Lumo seems to use open source models like maybe Nemo, Mistral, Open Hands, Almo, that's based on some coverage that was done on Lumo. And apparently it's picking the best one suited for a query without the user having to manually switch, but this seems very opaque. And again, this isn't even really confirmed by Proton directly in any of their documentation, so they should fix that. And to clarify the difference here, they're running this on a Proton-controlled server, but it's all end-to-end encrypted, so the server can't actually see what's happening. Again, this is different from DuckDuckGo and Kaji, who anonymize your queries to then send to the AI model, which still are fairly privacy respecting, but it's not a trustless model like what Proton is doing. Now, one thing that's important that you have to dig into a little bit is there is a free and plus plan. Plus plan offers unlimited questions and premium features, which includes unlimited chats, extended chat history, encrypted chat history, search and favorite your past chats, ghost mode, which is also in the free one, so I'm not sure what the difference is between ghost mode and free and plus, and also upload multiple and large files. So to access, I just went to lumo.proton.me. And if we give it a prompt here, what is end-to-end encryption and why is it important? Gives a pretty basic response. If we do it side by side, you'll see DuckDuckGo actually generates that far quicker. What I will say, just formatting and everything seems a lot better on DuckDuckGo's end, which is currently using ChatGPT. And if we ask it to explain the difference between VPN and Tor, see, like this is actually generating in real time, it seems like. I much prefer the way GPT via DuckAI seems to be formatting this, but none of this is inaccurate and it's not bad. How about what are the best practices for protecting my digital privacy? Enable 2FA, so far it's the same. Be cautious with public Wi-Fi. I don't think use a VPN needs to be the third thing. Use encryption, okay, limit personal information sharing, review privacy settings, use secure browsers, be wary of phishing scams, backup data, privacy-focused services. Actually recommends DuckDuckGo, which is funny. I was looking to see if Duck would recommend Proton, because that would be just awesome. So we went ahead and we kind of stumbled on something. So you need to use the web search feature. So all you do is click web search, go ahead and click there. I put a little typo instead of a question. Oh, I did enable web search. Sir, ma'am, cat. I enabled web search. Okay, it's taking its sweet ass time. Oh, okay. All right, I guess it's confused. Let's try refreshing the page. Duck seems to actually have access to real-time information, which is pretty sweet. And I didn't even have to toggle on search the web. Let's try this again. Web search, downvote. Not correct. Yeah, that's interesting. It could be a bug or something. Now to test out the integration with Proton Drive, I created a folder here which has an SRT file, which is a subtitle file, which is mostly text. I did a Proton doc, which is just a outline and kind of the what I used as a script for a recent video that we put out. And then I also added two images to see if either of those can be used by the AI agent. So we're gonna click upload, add from Proton Drive, and then Lumo test, and it says no supported files in this folder. So I don't really know what this is supposed to be used for. Okay, a PDF of the document actually seems to be there. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that, and then it shows it there. What is this? Let's see what it can come up with. Okay, yeah, so it seems like this handles PDFs so far. It is interesting it doesn't even handle its own documents. Like, why would I need... Are you telling me I have to export as a PDF and then I can use it inside the AI agent? I think that's interesting. And I don't think there's a way to access this within here. No, that's a comment. Yeah, I'm not seeing a way to access the AI agent directly in here. So really interesting choice there. So you might be asking a different approaches when it comes to privacy. So I want to go from worst to best and kind of clear up some of the pros and cons between the different approaches when it comes to your data. So the worst is going to be something just like ChatGPT, Gemini, even Claude. None of these are going to be privacy respecting. They're going to use data that you send to train their AI models. They're going to collect that data. It's going to be tied to a central profile. They can read everything. They can profile you. Some of them can even share that data with third parties. So, very not good. And those are especially true with the free plans. If you pay for these models, they actually have slightly better privacy policies where they commit to not training your data on those models. So at minimum, if you're using one of these mainstream providers, try to pay for them because that way they do have better privacy. From there, you're going to have tools like DuckAI and possibly Kanji's as well, which is going to essentially proxy through their servers to then reach the same AI models you'd otherwise use. Now, the cool thing is that this gives you pretty much the same experience as using the actual models, but with a lot better privacy. And I think these are overall really solid middle ground, and you can actually access DuckAI just from DuckDuckGo directly. So when you do a search, maybe you don't know something, you want to maybe dive a little bit deeper into it, you can go ahead and do it there. Of course, this is all assuming you're even interested in AI in the first place, which if you're not, I don't know why you watched halfway through this video. Now, the next best approach seems to be something like Lumo here. I don't know of anything else like Lumo, which does like end-to-end encrypted, but this seems to be a little bit more limited and not quite as good as something like DuckDuckGo proxying things, but this is definitely a little bit more privacy respecting than DuckDuckGo. Just keep in mind, if you're using something like DuckDuckGo, you're getting like 80% of the privacy benefits. This is just kind of taking you to like 99%. Now, there's one option I haven't really brought up so far, which I would argue is probably the best option. You can use local programs like Jan, like Misty, and all these things exist. And so what you can do is you can just download an open source AI model. It's completely offline, and you can even toggle if you want real-time data or not, kind of like what Proton is supposed to do. And then this stores everything on that database on your computer. And so you can pretty much have full access to this. You get access to a ton of cool features. I can load any document that I want into this, including images, PDFs, anything. And it's not limited by the limitations of things like end-to-end encryption. So I think that this is also a phenomenal option, and this is like 99% of the way that I use AI in my life is through things like this. What are some big news stories today? I'm going to try the web search again to see if this is just maybe that chat was broken or something. Okay, look at that. It's doing something. What are you getting at, Lumo? But no, this actually worked. So maybe you can't, there's a bug or something where if you like toggle web search on a chat that didn't already have web search, it doesn't work, but it looks like it did work when I started a new chat. One very big announcement that took up a very small amount of announcement in this blog, because this blog just says, oh, Lumo by Proton. But at the very end, there's something actually very important. So Switzerland lately has been kind of going after privacy and security, and this is something that I'll probably be doing more coverage for in the near future. But Proton here says, Lumo represents one of many investments Proton will be making before the end of the decade to ensure that Europe stays strong, independent, and technologically sovereign. Because of legal uncertainty around Swiss government proposals to introduce mass surveillance that have been outlawed in the EU, Proton is moving most of its physical infrastructure out of Switzerland. Lumo will be the first product to move, which means that Lumo is actually being hosted in Europe, not in Switzerland. Which is a bit interesting because if you go to lumo.proton.me and click learn more, it still says, oh, we're owned by a Swiss nonprofit. And literally, like, all of Proton's branding is Swiss privacy, and they mention that all the time. Based in Switzerland. For the record, this seems like overall a good move, so I'm happy they're doing this move, but yeah, kind of an interesting situation they're in right now, and this is a very minor but kind of major update that they just subtly attached to the end of the blog. As for my final analysis of the situation, for the record, this is not the first thing I would have asked Proton to do. I think there's a lot of other cool things they could have done, and I frankly would have just preferred if they improved some of the integrations between their current products and just improved on those, but this is fine. I think it's so far fine. I don't know if I'm going to be using this, especially because it doesn't really integrate with anything else too much in the Proton ecosystem. One thing you need to understand about Lumo, which is maybe going to make it or break it for you, is a lot of people use AI as part of their process when it comes to searching for something. And Proton doesn't have a search engine, and this is something you have to actively go to use. Whereas something like DuckDuckGo's AI agent, which is something I do find myself just accidentally stumbling on using pretty often now, mainly because I'll do a search, I'll go through a few web articles, and then I'll go, oh, okay, that was interesting. I'm curious, like, if I put this information together, like what an LLM will spit out. And then I'll just go ahead and click duck.ai. But that use case isn't quite a thing for Lumo. Like Lumo, you're going to have to log in and just go to Lumo just to go ahead and use your LLM. And at that point, you could have used any of the other ones that probably are better performing, almost as good privacy, or you could have just opened up your local program, which probably has better performance as well. So I think the uphill battle for me, at least, is going to be understanding where this could even fit in my workflow. Without just using it more, it's going to be hard for me to know when this is actually better to use than some of the other tools. Either way, I think the major feat that they're happy with, as well as myself, is their ability to somehow do end-to-end encryption with these kind of AI models. The end-to-end encryption aspect of it is very interesting and is something that hopefully other providers can learn from to build even better AI models. Let me know what you all think below if you like it or don't like it, and I want to thank our patrons and our Techlorians for making this kind of content possible, and I'll see you guys next time on Techlore. Thank you for watching.